All right, reinforcement learning, the third subcategory of machine learning. And of course, you can also use deep learning for reinforcement learning. But also don't worry about it too much, because this is another topic that we won't cover in this course. It's because, reinforcement learning is really a long and big topic by itself, and you can have a separate whole course and multiple textbooks on that topic. I have a chapter on reinforcement learning for beginners in my Python machine learning book. It's like 30 or 40 pages long if you are really interested in reinforcement learning with deep learning. However, like I said, in this class it won't be a topic. But just for completeness, because it's still maybe interesting to briefly talk about it in two slides, how reinforcement learning works. So reinforcement learning is about learning a series of actions. So here in this case, this is a drug design problem where we want to design a small molecule. So let's say we have a current state. So there's usually a current state in the environment. So the current state is that we have this benzene ring here, and the agent sees this current state and then has to take an action on it. So here the action would be to add this small chemical group to it, so this methyl group to the benzene ring, and this will be then updating the environment, or that will be updating the new next state. So it will then look like that. So we'll have the benzene ring with a methyl group attached. So the agent is the part of the reinforcement learning program that updates the current state, and it has access to the environment. So and it takes one of the possible actions, and there will be also a reward for taking this action and modifying this environment. So this is like going over multiple rounds until you would have, for example, a complete small molecule. And in other areas, you can also think of designing a chess game with reinforcement learning, where each move on the chessboard would be one action taken by the agent, and then you take these multiple actions, and there will be a delayed reward. In the end, it's about winning or losing the game, and then based on that, you optimize taking these actions. So maybe a more concrete example would be StarCraft 2. So that's a video game. You probably, I'm not sure, maybe you haven't, maybe you have played it. I actually played it, I think, back as an undergrad, long time ago. But yeah, it's a game where there are a lot of things going on at the same time. It's very complex, lots of things, lots of possible actions you can take at any given moment. And yeah, recently, a few years ago, DeepMind started working on designing reinforcement learning for StarCraft. So here, of course, the goal is not to design the world best StarCraft player. I mean, it's a sub goal, but ultimately you want to develop reinforcement learning systems that can generalize to other things, maybe self-driving cars, other more important things. But yeah, impressively, I think the current state of the art in StarCraft 2 is that they were able to beat most of the world's best players, human players. So it was actually pretty impressive given how complicated this game is. So many different actions going on and things going on. So in that way, that was actually pretty impressive. All right, so this was just a short note on reinforcement learning. But like I said, we won't be going into too much detail in this class about reinforcement learning.